Hey everybody, welcome back to the channel, The Real Rant Review. We're back with you for another rant review. Yes, I'm going to say a rant review on Super 8. J.J. Abrams directed, Spielberg produced in 2011, Super 8. Ellie Fanning, and some other good kids. Guys, I want to just go right into it. Spoilers ahead, you know my fucking reviews. You know my rants. The thing about this movie, guys, for me, is it was released in 2011, way before Stranger Things. If you read the Wikipedia, which I do have up, and I did want to go through it, but you could go through it yourself, and it describes verbatim Stranger Things, the tone of Stranger Things, the feel, the environment, all that kind of stuff of Stranger Things, the story, the plot, the kids. It's the same thing, a kid is kid. It's just the same fucking role as Stranger Things. So Stranger Things has a lot of credit to give to J.J. Abrams. And to Super 8. Great scene here, guys, in Super 8 where the train fucking crashes. Amazing. Has you gripped. And then you follow these kids as they try to find out more about this train crash and what was released from the train as an alien species form. It's classic Spielberg Abrams stuff, man. Really fucking cool. They keep the creature in the dark. I like it. At the end, I don't like it because they don't keep it in the dark. But it's fucking cool. Whatever. They keep you all the way through to the middle, to the beginning, to the middle, and the end. Not too shabby at the end. It's a little weak at the end, but it's okay. I will settle for it. Man, compared to Stranger Things, this movie is shitting on it as a series, as a whole series. I mean, and it takes from this movie. Stranger Things takes from this movie, and this is what I'm gonna fucking title this rant, probably something like that, because it's just Stranger Things has no comparison to Super 8. Guys, I recommend Super 8. If you watch Super 8, I've watched it a million fucking times. It has such a good Goonies feel. Just straight good Goonies shit. Mixed with Alien, War of the Worlds, with the kids, and so different, so better than Stranger Things. The Duffer Brothers looks like they took from, Mr. Abrams and Spielberg here. And, this is fucking crazy. This is 2011. And this movie is just not getting enough credit. It made a lot of money. Its budget, 50 million. This budget comes out with fucking like 240 million. So, man, it should have made a lot more. It should be talked about a lot more. It should give me a lot of respect, a lot more fucking credit, because it is the catalyst, the basis for a lot of these shows that are coming out and movies. And this one does it the best. Back in 2011, Super 8. You follow Ellie Fanning. You follow this guy here, Joe Lamb, and he lost his mother in an accident, guys. So his father and him are pretty depressed about it, but he wants to stick around with his friends and make a movie, a zombie movie. It's just so awesome to make this cool zombie movie and shit. It's really cool. You find them doing a big train crash happens while they're doing it. It's fucking amazing films and effects all the way, shitting on anything Stranger Things did. I mean, holy shit, what an awesomeness! And the kids survive it, and they find out that there's the aliens released, and from then on, it's about tracking down this alien. An alien terrorizes the town. Very fucking cool. They don't know what's happening. It takes place back in the 80s, I believe, so they think it's the Russians or something. So it's so cool. See, Stranger Things, once again. Taking place in the 80s, Russians, yep. So, biting from Super 8, and it's great. You follow it, they get to the aliens' base. He's able to free Mrs. Ellie Fanning, who was kidnapped, of course. Mention Will. Sounds familiar. Anyways, and then at the end, it's very emotional because he has peace with his mother. He's Mr. Joe Lamb here, and his father is able to overcome the depression and to find peace with the mother's passing, and everybody's able to solve the alien problem. He's the alien, just wanted to go back home, so he did. I think he crash landed here by accident, what have you, or he was kept here prisoner, so he wanted to crash home. There's Ellie Fanning, great, plays great. This kid's great, and this guy's always a character actor, whatever. I don't buy him, but whatever. The movie's great. I advise you watch it a million fucking times. Super 8, guys. Yes, it is better than Stranger Things. Stranger Things owes a lot of credit to it. I'm going to title this video that. I want you to leave your opinion in the comments. If you dislike that, that's okay. I like Stranger Things. I'm just saying that Stranger Things owes a lot of credit to Super 8, and it doesn't do that. People don't say that on YouTube. I'm fucking saying it. The Real Rant Reviewer has no problem with balls, big balls, and saying it. The Real Rant Reviewer, much respect. Love you guys.